In this video, I show you how to use Tableau Calculus to decide if the following formula is valid. Here we have a formula from predicate logic using an existential quantifier and an universal quantifier. And it's possible that this method I show you here differs from the one you learn in your course, because this one I show here is made for computers, so that a computer can apply Tableau calculus to a formula. So, as I mentioned in the last video, we start by trying to make this whole expression false. So, I'm not explaining all the details again. I explained in the previous video, and this here now looks really ugly. So I try to make this whole expression false. Now let's see what we can do with our line. Here we have the false in front of everything, and the outermost symbol of interest is those existential quantifier. Now let's see what we can do with that one. We have those universal rule here, where we have a false formula and the existential quantifier here. So what I want to do now is I want to apply this rule, and it will give me a second line. The rule says I'm using this expression again, and I replace x by some variable. So that's what I'm doing now. I will be left with g. Let's call this variable v1 or something. And then that's the only place where those x was, so I only have to replace it here. The y here stays the same. And I got this from line 1 with that rule. And in this case, I will not write a tick in front of that line, because a universal rule I can use as often as I want. So I'm not really done with this line. I could use it again if I want. So let's do something with the next line. We have again the false in front of our expression, and the main juncture is the conditional. That was the term I was missing in the last video. So I can apply now this rule here, which is a conjunctive rule. So I will get 2 more lines, and I will get both lines from line 2, where I apply the rule, the same rule. And I will get one line where the first expression is true. So in this case, this is g v1. And I get another line where the second expression is false. So that will give me the negation of the universal quantifier here. So now this is a conjunctive rule. I can apply this only once, so I will now write a tick in front of the line, and I won't care for that line anymore. Then we have line 3. This is atomic. I can't do anything more with it. Now let's do something with line 4. For line 4, we can use... let's see what we have. We have a false, and we have the universal quantifier. So this is an existential rule I can apply here. And it tells me to use the expression the quantifier quantifies over, and I will replace the variables by scalum constants. So that's basically looking like this. I get a new line with g, and now instead of the y, I'm writing a scalum constant like s1. So, and that's what I got from line for with the false quantifier rule. So, and I'm done with line 4. Now, I can't really do anything more with any of the lines, well, except that one, but this won't bring me anything further. So now, I want to define a substitution and see substitution, and then so I will write a substitution, and I want to try to make those terms unify with each other, so I will get a conclusion. So let me show you what I mean with substitution. I mean, if I have two lines and one of them, at least one of them, contains a variable. So in this case, we have one with a variable and one with a constant. So I can try to substitute the variable with anything so that it will be the same as a constant. Now, I can do this when one is a constant and one contains a variable, or if two contains a variables, but they shouldn't contain the same variable. Let me show you some example. Let's say if I have something like one expression like this with a variable here, and then I have another line with another expression, let's say with this one, then you might say, okay, here we have S1 and here we have the same constant, so these both unify, and here we have a variable and here we have another expression containing the variable, and you might think, well, maybe that could unify. But if you define a substitution for this one, if you define a substitution for this one, it would look like this. So you might say you are going to replace every occurrence of V1 by G of V1. Then you have to apply, that was one bracket too many. So if you have to apply the same substitution to all lines, so now I will apply this substitution to the first line, and I will have to replace V1 by G of V1. And I will also apply the same substitution to the next line, so I will get G1, and now I will replace V1 by those expressions, so I will be left with this one. And so that's the reason why this both these parts contain the same variable, and I have to replace I have to substitute the same variable in all occurrences, so these ones do not unify. Now let's get rid of this stuff. That's not what I wanted. So let's get rid of this stuff and let's go on with our task. So now I will define a substitution where I say V1 will be replaced by S1. And basically I have to apply the substitution to every line where V1 occurs. So I have to apply it to my line 2 as well. But in this example, it won't give me anything, so I will skip that. So I will apply it to line 3, and I will get a new line 3, where I'm replacing V1 by S1. And now, as you can see here, I have those new line where G of S1 must be true, and I have this line where the same must be false. So I have to close this branch. That means I try to make those formula false, and I could not do it. So that means This formula is, or let's use green, or it might confuse you. So this formula is valid.